Government gave me everything I needed to study the infra-world. They were interested in military applications. I was interested in seeing my family again. It's taken me some years, but I finally succeeded in creating this. Hello, my darlings. Helen. Laura. I miss you so much. I come to see them every day. Soon we'll be together. I'm working on a modified condenser that can communicate with souls of the infra-world. Speaking with the dead, Jody. Can you imagine?
What do you want from me?
I want you to help me talk to them. I want to hear their voices. I want to tell them what I'm doing. Until I finish my research, you're the only one that can do it.
I can't help you.
I haven't heard their voices for 15 years. Since that day, I heard them through a little girl. You. I'm begging you. Jody, do this for me.
Give me your hands.
My darling, I missed you so much.
Let us go, Nathan. You're hurting us. You've got to let us go. Let us die.
You're lying. Helen didn't say that. You did.
You're keeping them here. They're being torn apart between two roles.
That's not true. You're lying. I know they want to be with me again. I know they want to be with me.
You wanted to talk to them, okay? You heard what they had to say. Goodbye, Nathan. I hope you find peace.
Thank you. Hi, Jody. Good to see you again. Well, you put us in a very difficult situation, you know that. We can't let you go. We can't kill you either. We don't know what you'll do on the other side. So there's only one appropriate solution. We inject you with a neuroacid, which will put you in a permanent coma. Exactly what we did with your mother. A simple and elegant way to put an end to our collaboration.
Goodbye, Jody.
We will always be
grateful for your help.
Anymore. No one will ever be separated again.
What are you talking about?
The containment field.
I'm going to deactivate it. The infraworld will spread through our dimension. Life and death united in one world.
It's not just souls on the other side.
I've beaten death, Jody! Everything's gonna be just fine! You need to trust me.
Everything's gonna turn out fine.
Get help. Hurry.
Where's the rest of your team?
Vince and Nick?
They have 3 months' leave.
We're on a beach on some exotic island, no doubt.
Lucky bastards.
Yeah, I've got a couple of emails I need to send. You mind if I do that before we crack the bottle?
No problem.
Okay.
You keep entities in this lab?
Good God, no. They're all trapped behind the containment field.
Aiden? Is that you, Aiden? If this is a joke, it's not funny.
Why would Aiden be here?
What is it, Aiden? Where's Jody? Lead us to Jody, Aiden. Show us the way.
Right. Now where?
This way. Over there.
Okay, I get it. You want us to take the elevator? Is that it?
Freeman, I have level 3 authorization. He's with me.
I'm sorry, Mr. Freeman. You do not have the correct authorization for this level.
Maybe you could make an exception. I just want to show him.
Sorry, sir. This area is level 4 classified. You do not have the right credentials.
You gotta get us past him, Aiden.
Desk 42, hello. Hello? Hello?
I think you made a mistake. Could you check again, please? Cole Freeman and Ryan Clayton?
I'm sorry, you are on the list. My apologies. Go on through.
Thank you.
Hurry, Aiden. Take us to Jody.
Now where?
Something moved.
There! Jody's here? Jody!
Get out. Oh, Nathan! He's gonna deactivate the containment field.
What? Why? Why would he do that?
He's gone insane. He thinks he's gonna get his family back. We gotta stop him.
Containment field
the containment field. Oh, Christ, he's done it. He's done it! You need help?
No. No, I'm okay. Okay.
This way! No. Hurry up!
Don't stay here! We gotta get back to this place! Now!
There might still be a chance to reactivate the field.
It isn't already too late.
Jesus! They're out! They're all out!
The field isn't working!
Johnny! You're the only one who can stop this! Dawkins has gone mad! He took down the field! You gotta get rid of these goddamn monsters now!
I ought to kill you, McGrath. But the last thing the Infoworld needs is a son of a bitch like you. Get out of my way!
Clayton! Get me out of here immediately, Clayton! Agent Clayton, that's an order!
Consider that my resignation.
You're all gonna die here. You're all gonna die.
Come on.
Stop the condenser or reactivate the field.
There's nothing we can do. Let's get out of here while we still can.
Wait. There's one more thing I can try.
No.
Hurry! We're out of time!
What are you doing?
Portable containment field. Should protect me long enough to reach the condenser and trigger the manual self-destruct. Might be our only chance to close the rift. It's a long shot, but it's the best I got.
Come on, you're talking crazy, Cole. We need to get out of here and let the military clean up their own fucking mess. Jody, no.
Cole's right. It's our only chance.
I always figured I'd die a hero.
Been before, so there's no telling what we'll find down there.
How much time do we have after we've activated the self-destruct?
The system was designed to be activated remotely.
the explosion will be practically instantaneous. We're not coming back. Condenser zone is on the other side of that door.
We've got company.
Well, they haven't seen us yet. It's our only chance.
Jesus. I hope you're right. Or our little trip into the info world might come to a sticky end. Joe, don't get too close to them.
Go!
This.
Have you seen him?
No. No, I...
can't find them! I call them, but they don't come!
Maybe it's because they don't recognize you anymore! Your anger has changed you!
I miss them! I miss them so much!
Let me pass, Nathan! The condenser must be destroyed! You know it's the only way!
Missed you so much. You're the only one who can fix this, Jody.
Do it. Do it for me.
Jody, fuck, there you are. What happened?
Found what he was looking for. Come on.
The Black Sun. Just take this
and do
it.
No, those things are gonna slaughter you!
Take the damn belt and destroy the fucking condenser. Get out of here before I change my mind.
Inject you with a neural acid, which will put you in a permanent coma. Exactly what we did with your mother.
It's too late, Jody. It's too late.
Thank you.
I'm sick and tired of your stories! Jody, this time you're really gonna get it!
We couldn't leave each other. Our souls were bound together. I loved you and hated you for years. You were a part of me.
Being in love.
I love you, Jody.
Growing old.
I love you.
So many things I still have to do. Aiden?
We made it. Jody, we made it.
Aiden?
Ever since the Black Sun was destroyed, my memory has been disintegrating. I spent too much time on the other side. Now it's eating away at my mind, erasing what's left of it. My memories are all confused, slowly self-destructing, fading like a dream when you wake up. I'm losing my sense of time. I no longer know what happened before or after. Everything's playing inside my head at the same time. It's like watching the same film looping over and over again. A chaos of images with no order. So I've been writing night and day for weeks, trying to put my life down on paper. If I forget everything, these pages will be my memory.
3 months after the fact, the investigation continues in an effort to determine the cause of the accident that cost 283 lives on a Pentagon military base. Government representatives confirm that the authorities are working hand in hand with the investigators to shed light on this appalling tragedy.
The CIA is leaving me alone for the moment. I suppose they're too busy building another condenser to worry about me. I know they'll never abandon their experiments, now that they know what's on the other side. Honestly, I don't give a damn. Now I need to reconstruct my life. My life without Aiden. For as long as I can remember, I dreamt of living without him. Untied, without his constant presence by my side. I got what I wanted. I've never been so unhappy in my life. I feel like part of me has been amputated. I'm crying all day. I know it's stupid. Shit. I miss him so much.
Thank you. took months. Months of nothing passing by. Then I woke up. I knew it was time. Time to start again. To build a new life. It was so obvious. Deep inside, I always knew. I just needed the silence around me to hear what I was feeling. It took me a while to realize how much I loved Ryan. I'd been alone and sad for so long. I'd forgotten what it was like to love someone. We traveled as far away as we could. I had to learn to love again. To put my trust in someone, to stop fighting and running away. In short, I had to learn to live. Ryan and I never talked about it again. As if it all never happened. As if the other side didn't exist. As if it could never come back into our lives.